In this video, we would like to show you the daily function test for the corpuls3T. To do so, switch on the device. What we see here is that the home screen appears, and the device runs a self-test. The jog dial lights up briefly. Now we see the start screen showing the battery capacity, and that all three modules are connected here in the top right of the status display. The first step is the connection test for the individual modules. As soon as I separate the modules, the white bars change to a waveform. However, all modules are still recognized. If I reconnect the modules, we see the two white bars again.
In the next step, we will perform the function test of the defibrillator. We have three different test options for this. We have the test load, which serves as electrical resistance, the test box, with which you can also check the ECG cables during the monthly test, for example, or the corpuls simulator, which also has the option of importing different ECG rhythms. We have decided to carry out the function test using the test load. To do so, we connect it to the therapy socket at the back. The device then asks whether you want to mark this use as a test. We want to do that. Therefore, we press yes. In order to then select the energy, we manually select and perform rhythm analysis. And we reduce the energy to 50 joules. Confirm by pressing load. And deliver the shock. No error message appears on the display, meaning the test was carried out successfully.
As the next function test, we want to check if the printer is working properly. Printing out a screenshot is ideal for this. I can create it by pressing the printer icon for 3 seconds. The screenshot will be printed automatically. Here I can easily see whether the printed image is perfect, or whether I can see any red stripes that would indicate that the paper is about to run out. Up here, I can also see the battery charge level for all three individual modules.
In the next step, we will check the energy supply for the corpuls3T. We just saw that we can see the individual modules or the charge levels for the individual modules on the screenshot above. Each of these should be at least 30%. What we also want to check is if the charging works. This means that we connect the device either to the power supply or to the charging cradle. The LED up here should light up, and the plug symbol should appear in the display. In addition to the plug symbol, we now also see the charge state in percent. If I now remove the power supply, the LED goes out and the symbol disappears soon after. Now instead, it shows the remaining runtime in minutes. This should be at least 120. The function test is complete.
If there are problems with the CF card, it is full or missing, it will be displayed here on the monitor. If I want to change it, it's found here on the left in the inside pocket. I'll turn off the monitor now. We will not go into detail about the accessories, as there are many variables and equipment-specific differences here. Depending on what you have in the field, check your setup accordingly. Just a note here, you should have 2 sets of therapy electrodes. Packaging should be undamaged and not expired. I'll now divide the device into its 3 parts and carry out a quick visual inspection of the individual modules, paying attention to any external damage, chips, or cracks. Doesn't seem to be a problem, and everything looks as it should.
We have now successfully completed the daily test and just have to document the process according to local requirements. The detailed test for other accessories such as hard paddles can of course also be found in the instructions for use. Here you will also find the list for the monthly check, which we have not gone into any further. So we are done. The device is reassembled. We are ready for a mission. We hope you are too, and we'll see you next time.